in the great city of Chicago, Illinois. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Arizona Cardinals and the Chicago Bears.
Tucker McCann set to kick off.
The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. To speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Dante Hightower.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26.
Middle.
Out of the gun. Here's Josh Rosen. And he finds Montgomery complete. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 11 yards there. First down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Here's Rosen. He rifles one that's intercepted. Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line.
At the 38.
Offensively, a far from ideal start there with a pick on the opening drive.
Yeah, not exactly what they were looking for. We know that. That's pretty obvious. The beauty, though, is it's happening early. If they don't panic, they don't compound this problem, they've got a long way to go and a chance to get back in it.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. After the turnover, here's Murray. Being chased out left. He's going to take off with it. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Now left side on the swing pass. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 7 yards there and a first down.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
At the 4-yard line.
First and goal, a chance to convert that early turnover into points. Zone touchdown, Arizona.
To number 16.
From 4 yards out, and the Cardinals have taken the early lead. Heck of a start to his season. He had two touchdowns in the opener last week, another one here in week two.
Well, I don't want to call him a touchdown machine this early, but sometimes you get locked in, you know, and you feel good about things. You get into that zone, and those touchdowns come in bunches. He may be off to that kind of a start.
Like he was shot out of a cannon. I would imagine success this early, great momentum going forward for the rest of the year.
He keeps this up, they'll soon be chanting MVP anytime he touches the ball.
McCann's got it teed up. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
They're on the 20-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. Give him 8 on the play, and it'll be second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Looking to throw again on second down. Rosen, oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. The catch and run pays off to the tune of 35 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. And he won't get much. Maybe a couple. Down inside the 35 to the 34. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep them to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. Play fake. Here's Rosen. And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. Dante Hightower with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of 7. On fourth down on is Dustin Colquitt to kick this away. He punted 4 times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. This is fielded inside the 5. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there. And the Cards are going to have the football with a 1st and 10 deep in their own territory. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they will start this drive with just terrible field position, backed up inside their own 5.
But we have seen teams be bold here and take shots, right? Sometimes you go max protection, make it a one receiver route, and take your shot downfield and see what happens. And occasionally, we've seen success occur.
Smith catches left side. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Dancing to his left. Now he'll pull it down. And he is out of bounds, able to get it across the 20-yard line. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
On first and 10, here's Murray. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And this will be caught at the 30. Touchdown, Cardinals! Andy Isabella, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Cardinals now adding on to their lead.
It's not much as perfect in football, but that's about as close to it as you're going to get. Score, force a punt, score again.
And both drives are impressive. The opening drive was, that last one was. Now on the other side, though, what's your psyche? You're really behind the eight ball.
You got to make sure you just hold in there. Survive the early storm. Relax a little bit and try and get back to your game plan. It's way too early for panic.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. And now here's a carry heading left. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you're doing like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. As they run the counter play. And he'll take this one for about 4 up to the 40.
Number 41.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
From the 40 now on second down, Rosen, he's going to air one out. Oh, the rookie nearly had the pick, probably should have had it. Third down now.
Incomplete.
I'm not sure it made a difference on that play, but one thing to keep in mind, here in the early part of the year during a day game, the sun does play a factor on deep balls.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. To throw is Rosen. And that is incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's 4th down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
Here's Dustin Colquitt now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Taken right on the 30. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And the Cards will take over. First and 10.
At their own 29-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. It's been a good first half so far. They're up 14-0. Points here, that could really put them in command before intermission.
Yeah, and it's all well and good what they're seeing and how they're feeling right now. But this is the NFL. How many times have we watched 14-0 leads evaporate and quickly? So how have we seen them combat it? Continue to run your offense, but don't back off at all. Don't start looking at the clock. Don't start thinking about, hey, just take care of the football. Keep attacking. Usually the best way to maintain control.
The 40 and all the way up to the 45-yard line. 16 yards, a first down.
He's obviously a bit of a shorter running back. Sometimes when he goes up the middle like that, he gets lost in there, and then he pops out for 10, 20 yards.
I actually asked NFL linebackers if that was true. Do you actually lose sight of some of the smaller running backs? And all of them confirmed that that can be a problem. Think of it this way. Two of the top running backs in NFL history, Emmitt Smith, Barry Sanders, both 5'10". I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Murray again, second and 10. Now he lets it go deep for Kirk. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up third down.
10 yards to go.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 18 on that one, and the Cardinals have a first down.
A gain of 18.
Well, we can talk about it like it's just a basic route, but how about the timing on this one? Lined up on the right, runs a deep in route, and how about the throw? Right on the money. Bam, puts it right in there and on his hands. Nice completion, really good pickup.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Now Murray again, forced out to his left, and he's going to keep it here, and he is out of bounds inside the 30. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
To throw again on second down. Murray, he'll get that complete to Albert O. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. That one, a first down pickup of 8. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14-0. A reminder coming up at halftime, we'll head to Orlando. Standing by there, Jonathan Coachman. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL in this second week of the regular season. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. Another first down as they call his number again. He's got 15 yards here.
They scored touchdowns on drives one and two, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. Here's Murray, a quick throw complete. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown.
Touchdown.
A 7-yard touchdown grab. There the Cardinals push further out in front. So simple math here. The first half, they've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
Taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
20-yard line.
Offense ready to go for their next drive. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
A second and 11 from the 19. Now Rosen. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
First and 10.
And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number one on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you play in the back seven on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. And he is a Bella with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at their own 42. From the shotgun, it's Rosen. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. From the gun, it's Rosen. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
They'll look to throw on first down with Josh Rosen. Going up top for Miller. And this is going to be intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So that is three interceptions now in this first half, and you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest, we're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here, but he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20.
To throw again, Murray. And that one will fall incomplete.
Intended for Andy is
block here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 36. And he'll take this back down inside the 20.
So first thing crossed my mind is why didn't they just sit on the lead and take it to the locker room? They're in good shape.
Absolutely. And from this spot on the field, now you've given the other side a chance for points here going into intermission.
Yeah, you changed the momentum of the game, and it's something you did not need to do.
Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts.
4 yards.
As it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half.
At the 14-yard line.
On that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. But now it's Rosen looking. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Javon Wims, the intended target, and it's third down. So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and 6. Rosen will throw. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Snags it for the pick. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Intercepted by the Cardinals. They'll take over first and 10 at their own 9-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something they feel is somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go 4 verticals, because why not? And he fires one that's intercepted. Eddie Jackson picks it. And he will be brought down as time is now run out. This first half of action. So we have reached halftime with the visiting Cardinals out in front as we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach.
Kickoff for Chicago.
The Cards with the lead, and they will get this football first as the second half gets started. On the return, Tremont Smith. The lane opens here. He's past the 30.
Tremont Smith on the return. The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 37-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And last time, one play interception, so this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action.
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Murray now on first down. That ball complete to Isabella. Touchdown, Cardinals.
Andy Isabella,
44 yards. And the Cardinals turning that interception into a touchdown.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that, truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches. He's been the headliner. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half, other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Now a handoff as they run left side. And not a whole lot doing there, as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Now third down is looming, a pickup of two on first down and just 1 yard there. Third down now, and those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. Here's Rosen to throw. He's going to wind up and air it out. And now here's another interception. Picked off near the 42. And they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And last time out, another touchdown. And I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the fourth quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you, because this one's just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats? You and me, trying to get to the airport.
That's
the road
true.
To be fairly
that,
clear
that
by the time we have to leave the booth.
Give him nine there on the first down completion.
Second and one.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able. That's going to be caught by Kirk for a Cardinals touchdown.
Christian Kirk.
Christian Kirk with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Cardinals turning that interception into a touchdown.
Is good.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is, just what you said, you've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side, because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. Not much there, only a yard. Now we're at the 41, second and nine.
Second and nine.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. On first down, it's Rosen. And my goodness, another interception. Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And they will score. It's a pick six for the Cardinals touchdown.
Take that.
Tucker McCann.
This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone.
Now a hit and a loose football. And the Cardinals have got it, going the other way.
As that ball got away from him, and he saw the opposing team recover it.
You felt his pain?
Oh, I felt his pain, and you know what was going through his head. Tuck it away. Take care of the ball. All the things he hears all week in practice, he didn't carry it over into the game.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Throwing now is Murray. And that's going to be caught by Kirk for a Cardinals touchdown.
Complete to number 13.
Christian Kirk there to make the grab as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. It's been quite, and oh, he takes off with it. It's a fake. And he will not make it to the goal line as his try for two is going to come up empty. But that's little consolation to this defense as they have been porous all game long.
McCann's got it teed up.
This will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough because we always talk about it being a team game and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
56, right there, 56.
Now a handoff looking right. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. From the 39, Rosen. He'll let this fly deep for Quinn. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness.
Too many zeros on the stat sheet thus far. No touchdown passes. No points for his team, but he remains undaunted. Still attempting to get his team on the scoreboard, firing the ball downfield.
The Bears on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. The Bears on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Now it's Rosen. Escaping the pressure right. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. They'll try and throw for it with Rosen. And it is incomplete. The Bears tried it on fourth down, unable to convert. Then the Cardinals will now take over with excellent field position. Down, Murray. This one caught by Isabella. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. And give him a gain of 37. They come out with one back and three tight ends.
It looks like a jumbo set with three tight ends here for first and goal.
This will be caught at about the five. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona.
Touchdown.
Chris Carson, his third touchdown now on the year as his guys continue to pour it on. As that lead just swells and swells. Look, this has been dominance in all three phases, offense, defense, and special teams.
So don't we have to give a lot of credit, not just to what we've seen today, but the preparation in advance, coaching staff, commitment by the players to the game plan, and being ready to go in this one. You're exactly right. Clean sweep. And boy, they're going to celebrate this one after it's over.
And on the other side, this is the game film you just flush and never go back and review. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. Now Rosen looking to throw. That's caught by Trey Quinn. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Here's Rosen. They'll find Miller. That's complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. It's a gain of 34. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 27-yard line.
On second and 11 now. Rosen, he'll get that complete to his tight end, Komet. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defense side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
And this is caught. Well, they get one back, picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big. So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give them credit for that. Too little, too late, but no zero. Oh, you're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Cardinals take over first and 10. at their own.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on three games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We, you know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game, and that's always puzzled me a little bit.
Murray's going to look to throw this thing. Keeps himself upright, but he can't get away forever, and down he goes. Khalil Mack able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time.
It's second down.
After the sack on first down, Murray.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and digging themselves a hole that they can't get out of.
He'll rifle this one deep right side. That's caught inside the 20. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Looking like they're well on their way to a 2-0 start. All smiles right now on that sideline, isn't it?
As well there should be. It's hard to win a game in the NFL. We hear it all the time. We know that it's difficult. But guess who's smiling? But inside is thinking 24-hour rule, because we're going to have to play again next week.
Boss man.
Oh, without a doubt. The head coach, he wants them to feel good, but at the same time, find a way to keep improving.
McCann's got it teed up. Fielded in the end zone. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. The line prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in a game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done.
And now here is another interception. Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And he will score. Touchdown, Cardinals. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
McCann's got it teed up.
Set to kick off.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't. Because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10.
Mike, 56, right there, 56. Quit talking about it and bring it. Mike's 56. I'm coming, baby, I'm coming, baby. 56 is the mic. 56 is the mic. Let's go. Mike 56. 56 the mic, boys. 56.
One final shot here for Rosen. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And my goodness, another interception.
picked off at the 16. And that will write a finish to this ball game.
Today's final
score. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Cards, it was a great all-around performance as they come out of this one with the victory. And they'll return home next week to take on the Indianapolis Colts. Meanwhile, for the Bears, they'll drop to 0-2. And they'll be at home for one next week as the Baltimore Ravens come to town. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gauden saying so long, everybody.
Yo, who told us we ain't gonna win, man? zone. Really?
Yeah, we did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business, whole team got wins. And the wheels suspended, I told them.
What I told them.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was popped, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I gold it again and again. Who was the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he folding again and again. I'm in the
what?
I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the
what?
You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with it, so what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. Hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10, 10, 10.
Yeah, I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, I'm turning knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Running up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating round here. I'm the GOAT, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I'm with the Cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, no fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these odds ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe for the cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only winning is exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L.